Hey everyone, Micah here with Electrek, and today we're reviewing the eCell's Supermonarch Crown electric bike. This e-bike has dual suspension, dual motors, and dual batteries. Oh, and it puts out over 2,000 watts of peak power. It's pretty awesome. Let's check it out.
Right off the bat, I can tell you that this e-bike is a masterclass in excess, but it's that excess that makes the Supermonarch Crown all-wheel drive 1500 not just so much fun, but also such a capable e-bike. Let's start as usual here by checking out the specs. In terms of performance, with the pair of motors putting out a combined over 2 kilowatts of power, I can get up to around 32 or 33 miles per hour on flat roads, or about 52 kilometers per hour. Those motors are powered by a pair of 52 volt batteries, adding up to 1,638 watt hours. The range is super variable depending on the type of riding you're doing. By choosing really efficient pedal assist, that battery could likely take you 60 or 70 miles or well over 100 kilometers. If you're using throttle only though and powering up sand dunes or some other inefficient terrain, you might only get 20 miles or 32 kilometers. Average riding will probably net you somewhere closer to 40 miles or 65 kilometers, but again, these types of e-bikes will have vastly different ranges depending on how you ride them. Suffice it to say that 1600 watt hours is a lot of battery. Compare that to a typical 600 watt hour battery on your average e-bike. Next, let's check out the components here. This full suspension e-bike rocks an RST air suspension fork up front and RockShox Monarch RL shock in the rear. The hydraulic disc brakes are powerful 4-piston Tektro Dorados with big old 203mm discs that are much chunkier than normal at 2.3mm thick. That means they can handle more heat when bringing this 95-pound e-bike to a stop repeatedly. For pedal assist, there's only a cadence sensor here, which is honestly kind of a bummer to me when I see other e-bikes in this price range rocking torque sensors, but that's pretty much my one complaint on the component side. Let's see, you've also got here a Shimano 10-speed transmission in the rear, a color LCD display up front, built-in lighting, and a pile of accessories that come with the bike, including mirrors, a nice toolkit, battery-powered tool inflator, helmet, gloves, pannier bags, etc. Those pannier bags are actually quite nice too, and they really add to the cargo utility of the bike if you're going to use this as sort of an all-around town kind of e-bike. Alright, but enough about parts. You came here to hear about the experience of riding this bike, right? So let's talk about what this crazy e-bike is like to use. First of all, it's a full suspension e-bike which can handle just about anything. Now with those giant fat tires, it's not the most nimble for trail riding, but it is more nimble than I expected, to be honest. I mostly kept it on the street though, which is where it makes an awesome urban assault e-bike. Riding this thing is like operating a tank, except a tank with acceleration that will have you holding on for dear life. These motors are powerful. Look, some e-bikes are silent, stealthy rides, and this one is not that. These motors are loud, the tires are loud, the e-bike has road presence, that's for sure. This is as close as you're gonna get to a motorcycle in an e-bike's body. That doesn't mean it's not pedalable though. You can absolutely ride it like a bike and enjoy pedaling to your heart's content. It even has 9 different levels of pedal assist to tune into the exact amount of assist that you want. But I'll be honest and admit that I rode throttle only most of the time because it's just so much fun. You can hit speed bumps and potholes like they don't even exist on this bike. The powerful motors simply pull you over and the combined suspension and giant tires erase nearly any hints of a less than perfect road surface. So what does something like this cost? You're sitting down for this, right? Okay, the MSRP is $5,195, with the bike currently on sale by eCells for $1,000 off, bringing the price down to $4,195. That's a lot of money, yeah, of course. But you're basically getting more than 2 e-bikes here. I mean, you're getting twice the motors found on a typical e-bike, the total power is more than double a typical e-bike, the battery capacity is more than double, you get dual suspension, actually nice parts like 10-speed transmission, 4-piston hydraulic disc brakes that are e-bike specific, nice V bulldozer tires instead of cheap Kendas, etc, etc, etc. So I'm not saying it's not an expensive bike, it definitely is, but there are a lot of nice parts here. Not to mention that the performance simply blows away nearly any other e-bike. This is not a typical e-bike and it is not for a typical rider. eCells has other dual motor bikes with 350 watt or 500 watt motors. those are more for typical average riders. The Crown All-Wheel Drive 1500 here is designed for the craziest of the riders out there, the ones that need insane hill climbing power or want to be able to haul a deer out of the woods with their e-bike. This e-bike is obviously excessive, but that's what makes it so awesome. And for some riders, excessive is exactly what they're looking for.
Thanks for watching, everyone. We hope you enjoyed that review of the eCells Supermonarch Crown. This is an awesome electric bike, so much more than most people probably need, but that's what makes it so great. All right, if you like this video, why don't you give it a thumbs up? And don't forget to subscribe so you can check out all of our future electric vehicle videos. We'll see you here next time.